Hi everyone, I was trying to find a good soldering iron that suits my needs, and after testing many of them, I finally found a soldering iron that has the best value for its price. And after watching this video, you will also agree with me. So let's go ahead for the unboxing. The word unboxing is probably too much for this section, as there is nothing much inside apart from the soldering iron itself. There is just a thick printed paper inside, which also acts as a partition between the soldering iron and its cable. And there is some basic information printed on the back. The first line says that the three wire grounded irons are ideal for professional service, while the soldering iron I got has only two wires. So the information printed here is not very authentic, but I will test everything in this video, so don't take any too early decisions and keep watching the video. The model I bought is 60W and its model number is 908. Let's have a closer look. As you can see that we have a knob here using which we can adjust the temperature of our soldering iron. The minimum temperature I can choose is around 225 centigrade, while the maximum temperature is around 450 centigrade. We will soon verify these values with a professional thermocouple, but for now let's have a look at the soldering tip. I really like this soldering tip because it is very smooth and coated with some material, due to which I can easily solder the components. The soldering tip is very easy to change, and many variants of soldering tips are available in the market. The heating element is right underneath the soldering tip. Be very careful while changing the tips because the frequent heat and cool cycles can make it very brittle, and you can very easily break the heating element. Now it is time to do some accuracy testing. I have an industrial temperature meter in my hand, which shows current tip temperature of 230 centigrade, which is very close to the 225 centigrade on the knob. This is very impressive. So maybe I should increase the temperature to 300 centigrade. And wait a few seconds. I skipped around 30 seconds of video, and you can see that the temperature is now hovering around 300 centigrade, which is again pretty accurate. So let's see what this thing can do at full throttle. It says 450 centigrade as maximum temperature, but I am really doubtful that this little soldering iron can reach that high temperature. Let's see. Now I could have skipped this part of the video as well, but I wanted to show you something very important. Note that the moment the temperature crossed 350, the color of the soldering tip and its holder started to change immediately. So if you don't want to destroy your soldering tip, then keep its temperature well below 350 centigrade. We don't need to cross this temperature for most soldering needs anyways. I had to lower my soldering iron's temperature after it reached 405 centigrade, as I don't want to destroy my soldering tip any further. But I got a better idea to test it without burning my soldering tip. Let me show you how. I have removed both the soldering tip and the cover, and then let the element reach its maximum temperature. To my surprise, it reached above 587 centigrade. Now this experiment clearly shows that the heating element used in 908 soldering iron is very reliable. This soldering iron is not going to burn even if you keep it on 450 centigrade all the time. Now let's find out how much time it takes from a cold start to the soldering ready state. To save your time, I am speeding up the video a bit. By the way, I have also attached a power meter to measure how much power it is taking during this time. Since the soldering iron is adjusted at 225 centigrade only, it is pulling very low power and taking a bit longer to warm up. It took around 2.5 minutes to warm up enough to melt soldering iron. It could have reached the required temperature twice as fast if we had set it at 450 centigrade. Maybe if you are in a hurry, then you should keep it at 450 centigrade for a minute and then set it back to around 300 centigrade for an even quicker warm up time. You can see how smoothly it melts the soldering wire now with this stock tip. I tried to cover every aspect of 908 soldering iron in this review, so I think I owe you a click on the subscribe button. If you like my video, then like it and share it with your friends. See you soon with another useful video.